Hello children, once again you all are welcome to your channel Geography for Success. This time I am going to talk with you a few tips regarding how to do the MCQs in the exam and what all things you should keep in mind at that time. It will be applicable in all the different subjects, especially when we know it very well that at this time the type of question paper you are going to get is MCQ, right? Board has decided to give the question paper in the form of MCQs. Now, how to deal with that? That is one of the important challenges for most of the children at this time. So, I'm going to tell you a few important things which you should keep in mind when you are appearing for the exams. Okay, so let's start with it now. The first thing you have to keep in mind is when you get the question paper, first you go through it properly and very slowly, right? And if you are starting with, suppose, the first question you have read once, if you are still having any doubt, read it again, then you will find it a little better, right? So this way, you, instead of doing any hurry, be very calm at that time and read the questions very carefully, children. Okay? And once you have read it twice, then you think of the answer which comes in your mind immediately. After reading that question twice, you will get some answer immediately in your mind, right? And then that is the time when you read the other options which are given to you, okay? In the options which are given, out of all those options, suppose you are reading all the four options which are there, right? Always you should read each and every option properly, right? Out of all the options, one or two options are there always which are totally wrong in that case, okay? So which option you find is not at all applicable in that condition, right? As an answer, so just leave it away, or you can say that can be eliminated at the first moment, right? So what you have done is, first of all, read the question properly, right? Again, if you feel like, again, you can have a quick reading of it, right? When you read it, you'll find immediately the answer which comes in your mind, okay? So just keep that answer in your mind on one side, and then you read the options given to you, all the options which are given. Out of all the options, you'll find one or two options are there which are not at all applicable in that condition. Okay, so you can easily eliminate those options from there. Okay, now what you're left with is the rest of the options which are there with you. Okay, now the next thing what you have to do is try to decipher the correct options carefully from all the angles. That means whatever options you feel that it can be this or it can be the other one. So those options you should read very carefully and try to understand what it wants to say, right? And from different angles, try to check that which option is more, you can say, applicable in that condition. So this is the way you can get a correct answer. Then after that, choose the correct option when you are going to get any one option which is perfect out of all the other options, which is perfect in that condition, that will be your correct answer for that question. Okay. Now, after that, instead of the questions which you don't know at that time, right? Once you are giving the reading of the question paper, one question you have done, second question you have done, suppose the third question you are not very clear about it, okay? So instead of wasting any time, children, you just leave the third question for that moment and move to the next one. Because children, one thing you always should have in your mind from the very beginning of the paper, that you have got a very limited time, okay? So you have to work accordingly. Time management is the most important thing which you should have at the time of when you are giving the exam, right? So instead of wasting any time on those questions which you are not able to do, just leave those questions for the next part, okay? once you do all the questions which you know very well, you attempt all those questions first, right? Then it comes the turn of those questions which you are not so clear about. Now, after that, what to do now? Come back to the questions which you had left in the earlier part, right? Now, it is always suggested that don't leave any question without any answer, right? Always you should answer the questions, even if you don't know anything about it. Is it clear to you? Because you know, children, when you don't give any answer, it's going to give you zero. But when you give the answer, even if you don't know, just try to answer in that case. So in that condition, it may happen that it can give you marks for that. Okay, maybe the answer which you have chosen, that is correct. So in that case, you may get some marks for that. Understood? So you make it very clear in your mind that you don't have to leave any question at all without answering, because there is no negative marking. This you all know it very well, right? So just keep on answering. Now, when you are left with the rest of the questions which you don't know, which you are not so clear, then what you have to do is, the first thing comes in your mind. Suppose you are reading the question. First option which comes in your mind is as the answer of that question. You can choose that. Okay. If you will start thinking of it, whether this is correct or the other option is correct, then you may get confused in that, and that will cause wastage of time also, right? That will take more time in that case. Okay. One more thing, children. When definitions have been asked, right? Something very important to tell you here. Sometimes, you know, definitions are asked in the question. Now, when this type of question has come, make it a habit that you are going to read the definitions, every word of it, very minutely. Don't leave any word out of it, because that may change the meaning of it. Clear? Now, suppose the question is, what do you mean by contour interval? In reference to geography, we can discuss this here. What do you mean by contour interval? Now, what we have discussed in this, the earlier part, first thing is that the options which are given, out of all the options, the one or two options are always there which you feel that these are not at all going to be correct. They are not at all close to the correct answer. Right? So now in this question, you are getting the options first, second, third, fourth, and the third and fourth options are not at all very close to the correct answer. So you can easily eliminate the third and fourth option, right? First thing you have done. Now, the second thing, first and second options are left with you, right? The difference in height between two contour lines is the first option. Second option is the difference in height between the two successive or consecutive contour lines. Now, which one is going to be the correct? Second is the correct answer for that. You can see these are very similar to each other, right? So children, you have to be very careful while answering the questions in this way. Okay, so in this case, the second answer is going to be the correct answer for it. Clear? Now, one more thing I want to tell you here, children. Suppose the MCQs are actually quite difficult to remember, na? The every point, it's very difficult to remember. So always it is advisable that when you prepare the chapters, right, when you prepare any subject, make it a habit to prepare notes. Notes means always you should follow a tabular form, right, in very short tabular form, or in the form of a flow chart. You can write the important points, and that is, you know, why it is suggested to do like this. Because you know, children, when you are going to give the exam in the morning, right, the earlier night, if you are going through the chapters, at that time it's very difficult to go through each and every chapter line by line. Okay, so for that purpose this works a lot. when you have prepared your notes, like point wise you have made the notes, or you have made a flow chart like thing, right? Or tabular form, in table you have written all the important points. So this is going to help you a lot at the last moment when you are going to go for the exams, right? Just you will have a look of it and you will get everything in your mind. Okay, so this is the thing which is always going to help you when you are going to appear for the exam, right? Now, one more thing I want to tell you here. When you are reading the questions, children, a few things are there which generally are not noticed at all by the children, right? Like, you know, negative words. Okay, be very, very careful when you are reading the question. Please be very careful to read the negative words in that case, right? If one misses out, you can see here, not, the whole meaning of the sentence changes, right? If I say in this way, I have to go there, I have not, or I don't have to go there. So this is a negative sentence, okay? I don't have, I have. So when you won't read it carefully, you will miss out that not or the negative word, right? And even if you know the correct answer, you are always, there are chances to give any wrong answer in that case. So you should read the question ultimately. The thing has come on the same point, that the reading of the question should be done very, very carefully. Okay? And one more thing is there. For the MCQs, you should have a thorough knowledge of the chapter or the topic. All the concepts should be very, very clear to you, so that you can answer each and every point. Whatever may come from that entire chapter, you will be able to easily answer that. Okay? And another thing that plays a very important role in the case of any of the exams, right? Time management. Time management is very, very important, children. Again, if you feel like total 40 questions are going to, 40 marks paper is there, okay, so maybe 40 to 45 minutes are sufficient to do the paper. After completing all the questions, you should have with you 10 to 15 minutes to revise the paper, right? That is most important part of it. Again, once you have done the paper, after that 10 or 15 minutes should be there in your hands to revise the paper. Each and every question should be again revised properly. It may happen that you have opted for some wrong answer and you will be able to correct it when you are doing the revision. Okay, children. So these are a few important tips for appearing for the board exams. Board exams or the pre-board exams, whatever type of exams you are having, if you are having the MCQs in that, all these points are going to help you in the exams, right? Even in the competitive exams, this should be kept in your mind, right? So these are a few important tips for the MCQs. Okay, children? And last but not the least, you should have confidence in you. You can do anything, right? So all the best to all of you for your board exams.